Well, I just finished watching Mr. Jones, so let's take a look at the trailer, and then I will tell you what I thought.
It's time to wake up, Sleepyhead.
We have to get out of here.
Scott, the other world, it's coming over us.
I just hung this thing in the front window of the gallery, and it stopped traffic.
Nobody knew who he was, and nobody still knows.
We are out of phone range.
We're gonna be fine, but look where we are.
Whoa! Hey, I was thinking you and I could start a nudist colony here. What do you think?
Sign me up.
There's another one.
I'm standing right next to Mr. Jones's scarecrows.
I'm just gonna go in there for like 2 seconds. I'm gonna come right back.
Who do you think you're dealing with? Do you think this is like a painter or something?
Like, I know you guys think you're telling like a fun little story, but
what the hell?
You need to stop.
Whoa, this place is huge.
Oh my God, Scott Jones is here. Scott.
Penny, can you hear me?
Get out of that house.
You have no idea what you're dealing with. You don't know what he's capable of.
I don't want to go to what?
Don't look for him. If you think you have found Mr. Jones...
Get back inside! Go!
So that was the trailer for Mr. Jones. The movie came out this year, 2014, and stars John Foster and Sarah Jones. Yeah, Sarah Jones from Sons of Anarchy. It's a really good flick. The cover, the trailer, don't really explain a whole lot to you, but what they make it seem like is that Mr. Jones is the bad guy in the movie, which isn't true at all. Mr. Jones is this dream catcher in human form. These statues and scarecrows and little talismans he built are to help protect people from bad dreams, evil forces in your nightmares. You know, it's a really good flick. Majority of the movie shot as a documentary. Sometimes you get that Blair Witch Project camera angle, jittery, you know, just crazy handheld camera angle, but it's not too bad. Blair Witch about made me nauseous half the time, but it's shot really well. It's a lot of dark scenes in it that are kind of hard to see, but it's a really good flick. I was surprised, and when you hear about, you know, two people running off to a cabin in the middle of the woods, Lord knows what you're going to think about. One thing that really impressed me about this movie is the fact that there is no blood and gore in it. It's one of the horror movies out lately that doesn't see the need to just fill the screen with people getting killed and maimed and murdered and skinned and gutted to try to scare you. It's a very psychological drama horror movie, which is pretty cool, which is actually what I prefer. Don't get me wrong, I love my blood, I love my guts all over the place, but yeah, that's not scary to me. You know, I work in haunted houses, I have for years. This stuff I'm used to. It's the psychological thrillers that really work for me. But yeah, if you get a chance, Mr. Jones, got this at the $5 bin at Walmart, one of my favorite places to shop for movies. Check it out. I think you'll like it. It's The Evil Genius, Jason Wilson, checking out from Horrific Epiphany Productions. And...